So now that we've learned all about what integers are, how to add them together, how to subtract them, we're going to talk about multiplying integers. And it turns out that compared to addition and subtraction, multiplying integers is fairly easy. So to multiply integers, actually this is multiplying and dividing, we're going to follow some easy rules. So one way that one of my students used to do this, which I found really nice, is to make a tic-tac-toe board and then write P's on the diagonal and fill everything else with N's. And here's what this means. If you're taking a positive number times a negative number, your answer is going to be a negative. A negative number times a positive number gives you a negative answer. And a negative number times a negative number gives you a positive answer. Easy as that. Other than that, we're going to multiply the same way we used to. So let's try some examples out. So let's say we have negative 3 times 7. Okay, so here I have a negative number times a positive number. So I'm going to use the middle row. A negative times a positive is a negative, so I know my answer is going to be negative. And then 3 times 7 is 21, so my answer is negative 21. Easy as that. Let's try the following. Negative 5 times negative 2. A negative times a negative. That's the last row in my tic-tac-toe board. A negative times a negative is a positive, so negative 5 times negative 2 is positive 10. Let's say we have 0 times negative 20. Well, remember the multiplication property of 0? Any number times 0 is 0. Try 10 times negative 5. That's the very first row. A positive number times a negative number is a negative answer. Okay, so I can give you some more, but it's essentially going to be the same exact thing. So let me give you these for you to try out. A times negative 6 times negative 2. Here we have more than two factors. Remember back when we started talking about whole numbers, we called numbers and we're multiplying together factors. So here we have three factors. So when I multiply 8 times negative 6, my answer is going to be negative. It's going to be a negative 48. And then when I multiply negative 48 times negative 2, my answer is going to be a positive, and it's going to be a positive 96. So my answer is positive 96. So if you saw what I did, I figured out what my signs were. Positive times a negative gave me a negative, times a negative gave me a positive. You can do all your signs first, and then you can worry about multiplication. So I'll give you some more. The ones I'm going to give you is... going to give you a negative 9 times negative 2 times negative 1. I'll also give you negative 3 times negative 4 times negative 5 times negative 1. Negative 2 to the 4th power. Now what this means, if you recall back to when we did exponents, it means that I'm going to take negative 2 and multiply it times itself 4 times. So it's going to be negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. And a little bit of a different example is the opposite of 8 squared. Here, that negative sign is not inside the parentheses, so only the 8 is squared, not the negative sign. So what we're trying to say here is we're trying to say I want the opposite of 8 times 8. So the negative is not being squared, only the 8 is. Okay, so we talked about these rules for multiplication. The same rules apply for division. And essentially these rules, I'm just going to write the tic-tac-toe board again, just in case you don't remember how to write it. I'm going to write P's all across the diagonal and fill everything else with N's. And I have a tic-tac-toe board. So a positive divided by a negative is a negative. A negative divided by a positive is a negative. And a negative divided by a negative is a positive. So let's say that I have the following examples. 42 divided by negative 7. Here I have a positive divided by a negative. So according to the first row, my answer is going to be negative. And 42 divided by 7 is 6, so my answer is negative 6. Let's say I have negative 16 divided by negative 2. I have a negative divided by a negative, so that's going to be a positive. Negative 16 divided by negative 2 is positive 8. And I'll give you one more for you to try out. Negative 80 divided by positive 10. You can figure out what that will be on your own. By now you know the drill. One of the other things we're going to do is we're going to evaluate expressions. So let's try the following. Let's evaluate x times y when x equals 5 and y equals negative 8. So if x is 5 and y is negative 8, by the way, this is a positive 5, and y is negative 8, I'm going to rewrite this as parentheses. So x times y, x is positive 5, y is negative 8. Positive times a negative is a negative, and a 5 times 8 is 40. And I'll leave one for you to try out. Evaluate x divided by y when x is negative 12 and y is negative 3. And that's it for this section, short and sweet.